2K18 and now playing our TNA Impact show with our TNA champion being Joey Ryan, X Division champion Sting, Knockouts champions Mia Yim, and the United States tag team champions, NWA United States tag team champions being the Wyatt family. Actually, when I pulled out my PlayStation 2 to the game, I forgot I had this. You can see it. It's the NXT Impact game. This is one of my favorite all-time wrestling games. If you're playing against somebody with this game, it's great. The story mode's okay, but this game is, and the computer's too easy to beat on it. But if you're playing against somebody, this fucking game's awesome. Like, I love that game. But anyway, let's go play this Impact show. Oh, and I didn't show people a couple of things last time that I usually do to start when I play like the wrestling games. One's power rankings. If you look at our top 10, we got Shimmer Champion Rosemary, NXT Champion Marty Scurll, Roman Reigns, Tessa Blanchard, Bruiser Brody, Vader, Sting, Hulk Hogan, Randy Savage, and then you got Kenny Omega to round out the top 10. So Jim Cornette's number last on this. And then if you check out our schedule, like Raw is usually our first show of the week. And we got NXT, Monday Nitro, New Japan World, we got Eve Pro Wrestling, and then the next pay-per-view we got is Payback, and that's actually an Eve Wrestling pay-per-view. Let's go and get this show started. Just a preview of the show. You got title match with Gail Kim versus Becky Lynch. Braun Strowman's supposed to come out for an interview. You got Ultimate Warrior versus Sting for the X Division title. Finn Balor versus Baron Corbin, no kind of title match. We got Cage, NWA rules. Abyss versus Joey Ryan, that big bloody rivalry for the TNA title. And then end the show, Cage rivalry match, Bray Wyatt of the Wyatt family will face Jey Uso. So it should be a pretty good show. And I always think like this kind of looks like a TNA opening. And but I've been watching a lot of TNA on Twitch. Apropos, because I'm on Twitch. Oh, well, until this goes up on YouTube. I mean, TNA was such a like a mixed barrel from the beginning. You'd have good things and just god awful things. I mean, really god awful things. But it's one of those things like people look back. It's like with WCW. People look back and go, "Oh, it was worst wrestling ever." No, there's a lot of early '80s WWE. It's a whole lot worse. Wonder if they're ever gonna let you do commentary on this game. Like, just let you know the phrases, like, and like
Look
you have to
this
record
card,
and
I
you
just
have to
gotta
record
rub
them
my
and
hands
it would
together
put
and
them in.
smile. Singles. The wait is over. This
See
one's
if
for
Becky
all
Lynch
the
can
marbles,
capture
and it's coming up next. We have one of our breakout
that
talents
knockouts title for
versus
Mia
Becky
Yim.
Lynch.
I mean, not Mia, sorry, Gail Kim. Who? That Mia Yim got hurt, so this match is to determine the winner. Which I gotta be Becky. The hurt thing was my computer's glitched, and it switched the title to Gail Kim for some reason. It did it early, like it switched like Summer Rae also and got the like Intercontinental title, and I think it gave Marty Scurll my Florida championship to like that have an NXT in it. Which sucks because I was medium as the champion, so.
They're receiving here.
I don't know why, Michael. It seems like they get one of the biggest reactions each and every week. You think they'd be used to it by now?
Good shot with that background.
Here we go, ladies and gentlemen.
Up your knees.
Touch on Canada. We know she can compete, but how is she going to actually win this thing? These women
have
been sweat on their journey to this championship match. Can't wait to see it. Another thing is, she has all the tools to be a great one in this division.
We'll see how well she develops from here. Oh, I'm injured arm. Oh, looks like she hit the ropes and may have hurt her arm a little bit. Oh! Better moved out of the way. Ooh.
Yes, the Canadians are
Cole.
Oh! Nice move, I guess. I think Becky didn't really think of it quick. She's outside the ring right now.
You have to think hitting the finisher here could end this thing.
There she goes. She didn't get that count out. Be a ruling from the TNA board and see if, like, she's the new champion? We don't know. Braun Strowman is the man in any time. See what he's got to say here. Well, my biggest problem with the interview segments is also, well, they give all the motions and stuff is like for one guy or something or two people for all of them. Oh, I didn't mean to do that. Oh man, now that was for
Tony. We might hear from him. Well, things are about to get interesting. Here we go. Let's find out.
Fire!
not making any friends, but not really concerned about it either.
Well, he's going to kind of waste this. Bulgarian boot. By Braun Strowman. And a big guy that big, it doesn't have to be a little boy, does it? Got right back.
This one is over, and it doesn't sound like the fans are too thrilled with the decision here.
Oh, that's gonna be a future big match.
We've been waiting a long time for this. The championship is up for grabs right here. Next, it's Ultimate Warrior versus Sting.
Now be Sting. I'm Sting in this match as the X Division champion. And in true TNA tradition, you got a belt and you have no idea why or what the X Division represents. It's his former tag team partner, Sting faces the Ultimate Warrior. The challenger.
Remember, guys, the title is on the line here in this one. And I don't remember the last time the champ was in this much jeopardy, Cole. Tonight might just be the night the title changes hands. Big opportunity for him here tonight, Byron.
Yeah, it really is, Michael. And he doesn't seem like the type of guy who's just going to squander an opportunity like this. I expect to see him push the champ to the limit here tonight.
Where's this going?
I think it's about to be a highlight reel.
Wait a minute. We need to get some order back to this.
This is the champion's advantage.
Oh, an open source. Oh, break of the eyes. Oh! Thank you. I can't believe he went to that match by DQ, but I don't think Sting at any point, like, he was getting ready to hit him with the belt a couple of times. Like, Sting,
don't
I don't
move.
Think
we
gives
have a
crap
match.
About
coming
winning
up next,
the match.
We have Finn Balor versus Baron Corbin. Let's get this party started.
Baron Corbin. Took out Baron Corbin because he wanted to make a point against Finn Balor, and he couldn't make a point. Nope. Because the leader of the other club, which is for everyone.
Time for this. The championship is up for grabs right here. Next,
we have one of the best talents on the roster today.
And Joey Ryan versus Abyss. Bloody
title matches are what the
UK
WWE
matches
are
theirs.
All
the
about.
Network shut down because they were just wouldn't end, and they just were like just so bloody. Abyss, the first modern TNA champion, against Joey Ryan. So it's in a cage, NWA rules. See if Joey Ryan can keep this style. A lot of people are surprised when he won it. A lot of people are surprised he's been able to fight with this.
Yeah.
if we have time remaining, it will be another cage match after this break. Jey Uso. If this can be long, we might get there. I don't feel like it might not last that long. These two really go all out against each other. Ladies and gentlemen, we're ready to get this match started. Man, I'm looking forward to this. These guys never disappointed.
But can he knock off the champ here tonight? There's a lot of people who say he can't, but I actually kind of like his chances.
As we get underway here, let me remind you that this is the same city that produced the greats as Jerry the King Lawler, Jackie Fargo, and Lance Russell.
Hey, that's pretty cool. The announce team, which I heard over here, and Jackie Fargo and Tarzan. That's pretty cool. So, WWE Hollywood mention is, I think WWE's ever mentioned Jackie Fargo in the air.
Just taking on some offense. He's gonna have to find a way to fend off the champ here. You hate to think this way, but part of me thinks he might be on his head inside that
seat. Oh, yeah, man. I don't know. This is a big sign. I'm going to take your head off her. All the way against the cage. think it did. But this seems to be measuring almost everything. I think this one might be over. And just when I say that. Shot right there. Oh, what a close one. Oh, he's going in again for good measure.
Showing very few signs of life here. Yeah, there's no way he comes back from this. Might as well ring the bell now.
Proven he's worthy of TNA champion. Looked like he was done for sure. If he must have let the go away, he was able to get out. One more slam. Cage really didn't come into play here. He's just like overblown. These guys hit each other. They're just trying to beat the crap out of each other.
In just moments, ladies and gentlemen, we will have competitors locked inside steel. Don't go away.
It's Bray Wyatt against Jey Uso.
Going to settle
Wyatt,
the score.
U.S. Tag Team Champion Wyatt family. Going against Jey Uso and Uso. It's a grudge match. In the cage. When they learned that cage match was going, right, and there was one more match left, one more slot, both of these men were like, let's make it a cage, 1-on-1. Three best entrances in wrestling ever: Road Warriors, Old School Road Warriors, Undertaker, and Wyatt family.
Surround the ring, Corey. What are your thoughts heading in here?
There is nothing more barbaric than this, Cole. It's like we have a couple of caged animals locked up inside that steel. And on top of that, this match
match will undoubtedly have a big impact on where these guys stand in the next WWE.com power ranking.
Paying attention. Look how the Mancinos handled this mainly tag team. Cage did his smack, kept him by interfering. And Joe ran the best thing, it's like, making man on man, no weapons, or anything. He used the cage, and they didn't, they pounded the crap out of each other. Isn't over, especially after that attack.